Abraham Diaviver, hello my friends. Today I have watched the other night, because I'm paralyzed. In 3 days, in 3 nights, I stayed awake at night and I slept during the days. There is a fine time now in cruise from 1 week, but I cannot move from my home, because I have finally found my sister Artemis and I have passed my divine mission to her. And I am now free to do and say whatever I please. I am no longer restrained by the laws of Atlantis. Actually, the laws of Atlantia were enforced. You know, in Stargate Atlantis there are some hidden scenes. Only people from Atlantis can decipher them. Which makes me think that actually that sci-fi is a true recollection of events. Just like Babylon 5 is, because you know in Babylon 5 you have to watch very carefully and you will see that all the faces and all the teeth of the aliens are not manufactured, they are real. For example, Jakar has very small low teeth and crumbled together, they are his natural teeth. And the Centauri ambassador has sharp teeth, like sharp cannons, like you know, canine teeth, like wolves and vampires and werewolves. So I'm thinking that all these sci-fi movies and sci-fi series are depicting the truth. You know, there is a sci-fi series where there is a doctor, which is incidentally the scientist in Stargate SG-1, Captain Carter, which now investigates the monsters which lurk in our society. So it is a very complicated world. I have seen that galacticmessages.com has moved to another address. I do not remember now, but they have galactic messages from 4 or 5 sources. So I was invited on 13th of August this year, 2014, at Dracula's place. And you know, Dracula has some problems. He impaled a lot of people, he killed, he burned alive a lot of women, and you know, and because of all his sins, he has a really dark aura, and he seeks to repent for his previous sins by making meditation. He now stays 10 or 11 days in Vipassana. He is not allowed to speak, not even with his guest. He asks 500 lions because he wants to move. He wants to sell his apartment and move to Paris. He was in London, now he wants to move to Paris. He says that in Paris, in France, people are more noble than they are here in Romania. So he gathers money now, 500 lions per guest, but in Vipassana no one is allowed to speak with anyone. So if his guests are making evil deeds, he is not allowed to tell them anything. And he must clean after them and make food for them, vegetarian food, together with his wife. I remember how he employed his wife. Her name is Ligia, and he Lig space IA, and she's a bacteria from Agartha. You know, the bacteria from Agartha are really very complicated beings. They have a lot of DNA and RNA strains in their ectoplasm. That is why they have passed through many cycles, like the multicellular being cycle, then the monkey cycle, the color vision was developed, and the you know, savage in the jungle cycle, the cannibals are there, where reason is formed, and primitive as slave society, medievalism. And if we count, we only have to count the cycles from you know, from the Mayan calendar perspective. maybe also Carl Johan Kellerman is a bacteria. And when I'm seeing his photos, I realize this. So we have to come from universe to cells, or from bacteria to cells, from cells to multicellular organisms, from multicellular to monkeys, to primitive humans, to primitivism, slave society, medievalism, ethics, consciousness, spirit, light, created God, uncreated qualities, and one of those uncreated qualities is the truth. So I'm naturally telling all the truth, because you know, there are many people which are from Alcor here on our planet, which are fanatics in truth. They disintegrate anyone who is not telling the truth, because they themselves are not telling the truth. The Alcorians are naturally born liars. They can look at you smiling without the muscle moving on their faces and on their face, and they could straight up lie to you. They are Lemurians. They are from the red race. They have brown eyes and dark hair and red skin, brown skin. Red browns. So they are like the Indians from the, not as dark as the American Indians, but close, something between the Arabs, the Indians, and something like the Polynesian, because they are high. Their height is 2 meters. They are like a cross between Atlanteans and, you know, Arabs. Anyway, this is what I wanted you to know, that I am a few days away from reaching the level, the Christ consciousness, of the level of Jesus Christ, the true level of Jesus Christ. And I have met at that meeting on 13th of August someone who was, you know, there was a boy, 22, 23 years old, who is already above me at 57D. And he said about Dracula, my friend, that he spills his lime, his internals when he sees him, because Dracula has this nasty aura, this bad karma, which is reflected into all his energy bodies. So he seeks through repentance and meditation to clean up, and he unites himself with many women. He abandons those women because, like he tells Legia, I will give you 50 lions per day for you to cook for me and be a slave for me and be a servant for me, and you know, we will make sex, and you will clean after me, and we'll make you food for me. And you know, I need this. I need this here too, because I am so advanced in the test of Agartha that I cannot clean my room and wash my dishes. It is very hard for me. I have some very nasty pains in my left knee, my left arm, and my spinal column, and my teeth. One of them is broken into parts, and my teeth are 5 missing. So, that meeting on 13th of August was chosen by those spies which live from spying me. And you know, I was always amazed when I went to the meetings with my spies, because they have perfect teeth. Why do they have perfect teeth? Because they earn thousands of dollars spying on me and sending reports about me. So they have a lot of money to go in vacations, in holidays, and to fix their teeth. Why I'm not paid for my work? I'm like a beggar, like a slave for them. So, and many people treat me like a slave. They treat me like these spies from Dia and Sere and Sere are, you know, gods, and I'm, you know, a shit of the slaves. When in fact I'm a great god. But at that meeting on 13th of August, there was a girl which I could not see. She was a Lemurian. And she looked very nicely to me, and Laurentiu, which was Laurentiu Marin, the chief of the spies of Dia, he was very angry with me and said, I will not move from your path. And I did not say to him to move, because he's a black dragon with two heads, the dark star, the very nasty dark star kind, which spits 3 fireballs to each head and 6 fireballs in total every 1.5 seconds. However, this is the reason why he believes himself to be the reincarnation of Jesus Christ, the second coming of Jesus Christ, the reincarnation as a supreme God and so on, because he believes that he is the toughest dragon that there is, and no other dragon exists to challenge him. So, I wish to tell you that in fact there are many other dragons, monsters or dragons in Romania which have five heads. For instance, the emperor from Agartha, Valentian Tyrkar, Valentin Tyrkar, has five heads, and he's the same dark star as Laurentius, but he's three heads extra, and he can spit 15 fireballs per second. 1.5 seconds actually. And I have met also other dragons which I do not wish to. The boyfriend of my mother, Nicholas from Black City, is five heads, but he's a regular dark dragon, black dragon. He's not a dark star, so he only speeds five fireballs per second. Five large fireballs per second, not five, not 15 small ones. And at this meeting, the girls, which I was unable to see because she was sitting on the left of Lorenzo, and you know, Dracula told me, go and sit near her. But there was a spy who was guarding her, and he said, well, she will not move from your path, and I will not move either. So Dracula came up with a solution. Well, then go into the house and bring a chair for you. And I said to myself, well, I'm the leader of Romania in this world for 16 years. I will not move. I will not do this because I will feel offended, and then I will have to leave. And I feel that I have to stay and talk to this girl. But unfortunately, Laurentiu Marin was extremely arrogant, evil, and aggressive. Captured me, and he started to call me. Why did you call me shit? Well, I said, well, because you have decided for me not to be paid for my work for 16 years for Romania and the world, and our discussion went forward. And so that boy, 22, 23 years old, which is Alex the Wonder Child, he appears on TV because he's a light being like me, but unlike me, he has suffered an accident on his brain. He hit his head something when he was a little child, and he is always like I am when I am drunk or tired or drugged. So I am saying everything which is in me, all the truths in me. So he said that about Lorenzo, that he is extremely aggressive and I should stay away from him, that also he has a bad karma. And actually that girl, which I was unable to see, was Simona Halep. She is the number 2 WTA in the tennis women ranking. And she has about 6,000 points, and she earned about $5,355,000, $5.5 million. And she lives in Canada. And she was guarded by a fellow spy, which told me, you know, you do not have the right to speak with her, and no one has the right to speak with her. These are the, you know, the honor and the harmony and the respect rules of Lemurians. And I asked him, said, why? Because I was also number one in this world. He said, no, because you swore Romania, and that is why half of those $5 million and five houses with whom we intend to pay you were cut in half. And I said, well, then you will give me $2.5 million and 2.5 houses. He said, no, only 2 houses. So he said, you must cover with someone on position 60 on the WTA ranking. As I said, why did you granted me ATP points, tennis points? And he said, no, but considering that you will only have $2.5 million, you have to couple yourself with someone who has just the same wealth, someone like Sorana Kirsten, something like this. And you're not allowed to talk with Simona Halep. And Simona intervened, and she asked me, are you inconstant like I am? I said, yes, I am even more inconstant. I am sometimes number one in the world, sometimes I am number 100 in the world. So, And she laughed, and then I said first time, and I introduced myself, and I'm with the great God Apollo, Master of Philosophy and Arts, and I listed the 13 arts, and then I said that I am the one who leads this country for 16 years, and no one has shot me yet. And then Simona intervened and said, "Well, you say well when you are saying that you were not shot yet." And I was impressed, because none of my spies, although they hate me so much and they envy me so much, they did not dare to say this to me in the face. And Lorenzo said, "Well, there is still time to shoot you." But Simona, and then I understood that by her voice and by her spirit, because she quickly felt bored by all the aggressiveness of the spies, and particularly Lorenzo against me, she left. And when she left, That old spy, 40 plus, which was 40 years plus, which was guarding her, told Simona Halep to for all us to hear. And I looked at that, but I remained unconscious for a while, for a few days. I did not realize, only on my subconscious, on underconscious, I realized what happened. And she said, "Well, I will return on 11th of September at Dracula, and we'll have a meeting there." And I look at her, and I realize that she is in fact my sister Artemis, both by her speech, by her daring, by her courage, and by the fact that she is playing sports, so she's the goddess of sports and hunting. I wrote a message on Facebook to her account, and I said, "Well, I call for you to call to lead Atlantis," the whole damn message. Yes, and then I remember about this Atlantia Viver, and the fact that I saw a little girl, or a grown-up girl, or grown-up woman, saying Atlantia instead of Atlantis in the series of Stargate Atlantis. And then I realized that in fact she is, that actress is in fact a 4D being, a 4D light being. And if you will, see, I do not know, some episode in season 3 or 4 to season 3 is that. I don't remember which episode is exactly, so you will have to watch that one. But anyway, there are many beings of power, because they wish to have ethics, but they do not have there are many people in CIA which are like that. They have a lot of power and they wish to have ethics, and they call themselves ethical beings. But there are people like that CIA spy called, Cordy, I think. But he calls himself Ciple. He's also a Lemurian, and he has ethics, but he wishes to reach the consciousness level. And according to the latest calculations of Mayan calendar or Atlantean calendar, he will have to wait 103 years until the year 2117. He will remain here in Romania, perhaps, until his colleagues in CIA will reach the same level, because otherwise he wishes to help me, not to spy on me. And his fellow colleagues on CIA will ask him, "Well, who do you think you are? The reincarnation of Jesus Christ, the second coming of Jesus Christ?" So that is why he does not understand me. I have 612 dimensions now. He does not fully understand me. But I say to him that he, in order to avoid incarceration into a mental hospital, he ought to remain here in Romania. Or he has to resign from CIA, of course, by horse. My wind horse. So, I wish to tell you this, that many things have happened in the last few days. I was very close to my death. I probably will be dead in 6 months or so. But anyway, I cannot do anything in my house. I am completely off track. But I wish to tell all these things to you. I'm sorry if I was a little bit rough. So, what else there is to say? Goodbye, my friend.